Alright, YouTube. We have yet another game console to repair. This one is a Nintendo Wii. And just like the NESs before this one, there are two of these also. And they both have the same symptoms, basically. Basically, they're just dead. They don't do anything. So what I'm going to be testing first is to make sure we are getting power out of the power supply, which is 12 volts, and make sure that it's actually pulling current and is trying to do something. So we'll take a look. I got a monitor here set up to verify if it does try to output any video to see what we can find. Okay, so I have the multimeter plugged into the power supply currently of this Wii, and from what I can see here, we are getting 12.29 volts. That's without a load. So from what I'm gathering here right now is that the Wii does, in fact, have a working power supply. So, let's go ahead and plug it in and see what we can get. Let me go ahead and put the camera down real quick, because I'll actually just do this in one take. Let's see. I'll unplug basically a little makeshift adapter that I did here. I'll try to focus this on that. There we go. It's just the basically the gator clips and with little copper rod that actually is the right diameter to fit into the plug. So let's go ahead and plug it in. Let me grab the video cable. Plug that in and plug in power. Alright, power's plugged in, and we are getting a red light. So, let's see what happens. I will go ahead and try to turn it on. We're not getting anything on this monitor. Nothing whatsoever. Turn off my multimeter real quick because I left that on. So yeah, this is definitely not getting anywhere. I did hear a little pop through the speakers on the monitor, so it is trying to do something. We're just not getting any video though, not getting any sound other than a little pop. Oh, wait a second. So that was strange. It did something different. It actually gave out a black image now. But nothing beyond that. It reset. The picture went blue. Now it went black again. And now it's trying to boot. Let me grab a Wiimote real quick. I don't even have like the sensor bar plugged in or anything. It doesn't want to talk to the Wiimote at all. I don't know if that's just because I don't have the sensor bar on or something else is going on, but that is strange. I had to turn it on and off a couple times to even get a picture. So, with that, we're going to have to tear this thing down, see if maybe there's something clogging up a fan. So, maybe it doesn't want to turn on if there's something, you know, preventing fan rotation, therefore it can't cool down. Things like that. It's not getting warm or anything. Let me go ahead, though, and plug in the sensor bar and stuff, grab a Wiimote, and see if I can get it to go any further than this. Okay, I'm really not gonna lie. This is a first for anything I've ever repaired. It came to life, kind of like on its own, and it's working just fine. I mean, I really don't know what to do with this one. I'm very tempted. I mean, I really do want to tear it down and clean it out. I mean, obviously something was preventing it from turning on, and you saw it right on camera. It didn't turn on and then decided when I hit reset, it came up. What's interesting is the clock is off, but not that off, considering it, from what I understand, it's been dead for a little while. It is a day ahead, and it's got the hour off a little bit, but this thing's been ticking. The real-time clock on this thing has been ticking, but it's working. Like, everything seems to be working just fine. I'll just take a look at the settings on it. Make sure that maybe there wasn't something that may have been preventing it. I've never used a Wii, honestly. I've never used a Nintendo Wii before. And it looks like it just died. It actually just quit working? I don't think a Wii uses a hard drive, does it? Maybe it's having a hard time reading something? I have no idea. Yeah, it stopped working altogether now. You hit the home button on the remote. Nothing. Well, it had some life. And then it went kaput again. Hit reset. Really, nothing now. Alright, let's turn this one back off. And try turning it back on again. That is strange. So let's try that again. Now it goes to the settings screen. It seems like it's having a hard time reading from a disk, but I don't, like I said, I don't think a Wii uses a hard drive. Let me do a little bit of research on how a Wii works and what's inside these things. I'm gonna very clearly need to figure this one out because something strange is happening here. After being stumped at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and have this Wii go ahead and try to play a game. So I was given a game to try on it, and the disc is perfectly clean. I mean, there's like no scratch on this at all. So I'm going to go ahead and put it in, and I can't. There is a game apparently in there already. What's going on here? What's in here? Nothing. Okay, please insert a disc, but it won't let me put a disc in. So there is something, maybe with the drive. I mean, I don't know. Yeah, it's not even trying to pull a disc at all. Alright, well, I think maybe I have an idea what's going on. I looked it up. They don't have hard drives, but they have 512 megs of internal flash memory. Being it is not pulling a disc, I have a feeling it might be something with the optical drive, or maybe the drive's not getting power. Something's preventing it from working. So that's what we have here, because according to this, there isn't even a disc in here. That's not it. Yeah, let's go back to the menu. Let's go ahead and power up the other Nintendo Wii and see if we get any different results with that one. That one being the same issue, it will not turn on, which this one has apparently decided to try coming to life. So let me grab the other one now real quick, see what we can find. Alright, we got the other Wii hooked up. I have the back off the remote, because if it does turn on, I have to be able to sync it. So let's try this one and see what this one does. I can hear the optical drive making noise on this one. Once again, we have no video. See, that's weird though. The optical drive did make a sound this time, whereas the bottom one did not make a sound. Still no video. Let's go ahead and turn this off. Let's try this again. Well, the eject button does make the motor run on the drive. This one, it didn't make the motor run at all when I hit that button. But we're really getting no video output. Alright, let me hook up the other Wii back up and see if I can get it to maybe make any kind of mechanical noise. It's optical drive. This one's definitely not working at all, and I'm basically stumped now at this point. At least for the diagnosis, until I tear the thing down and start really looking at it, I really have no idea what's going on. I have a feeling it might be faulty optical drive on the bottom one, but that doesn't explain why it didn't want to turn on. Okay, and we're back to the bottom one again. And we'll go ahead and turn that on. Nothing, there's no noise whatsoever. And once again, this is actually just turning on and working now again. Nothing. Alright. No post, no boot, no nothing. Originally had the same symptom, then came to life, but has no optical drive activity. So, we're going to start with the bottom one, since this one is actually now doing something. So the top one I'm going to go ahead and just put back in the bag for now, or put it down here. It'll sit right next to the other Nintendos, and going forward, let's start working on this one. Okay, so here's where we stand right now. I have this Wii taken apart, and I diagnosed the optical drive is a bit of a problem. This drive has no life in it whatsoever. However, there is power making it to the power connector. So it is not an issue with power delivery at all. It's just the optical drive is completely dead. So this one will need a new optical drive, and I'm wondering if the lockup was maybe caused by this, maybe it was causing some bad bus activity and it was preventing the machine from booting. That's the only thing I can think of, because like I said, I mean, it's basically working now, and it does boot up with the data cable disconnected. I mean, it's not complaining one bit that the drive's not even plugged into the bus. It's just, in fact, if I take the remote and go to disk channel, it still says please insert a disk. So we wouldn't have known if there was maybe something wrong with this optical drive or not, but from what I'm seeing here, this drive is toast. It has no life in it whatsoever. So we'll probably have to get a new optical drive there, or I'll talk to the client and see if maybe if they're okay with taking the optical drive from the other one, because we don't even know what the other problem is. But if we have to get a drive, and if the client doesn't really need both Wii's working, we will make a Franken-Wii